So we begin part three of our three romantic themes of Indian paintings. The first DVD was Nayiks and Nayikas, Heroes and Heroines. Baramasa, the second season in their festivals. And this, the third, Ragamalas. Ragamala means necklace of raga or garland of melodies. This is a painted idealization of different musical sets or modes, but based on poetry that romances the music. So they are pictorial representations of melodies, visual depictions of music, ragamalas. No parallel exists in the world for this very unusual art form, but ragamala paintings became intertwined with those of the Nayik and Nayikas, the heroes and heroines, and even those of the six major seasons and major festivals. Many of them would appear to be the same and have similar images. These visuals portray different ragas. I will get to many specifics later on. A musical raga is a selection of notes set in a certain progression, with some more emphasized than others. Then the playing of these notes is done in an improvised way, spontaneously, Indian classical music. The state of the soul, it is said, is expressed by a series of sounds coming from the throat. In regard to the paintings of ragas, however, this is the comment written on the back of this painting. The crisscrossing of their instruments, the elegant poise of their fingers as they pluck the strings and glide on the frets, and their subtle eye contact, these all signal rhythms, syncopations, nuances, and subtleties. They convey with a mesmerizing, meditative intensity the enthralling delight of music making. This is the perfect visual expression of a musical mode. Ragas are traditionally seen as male, based on five main or emphasized notes, the leaders, and raginis seen as female, with seven, eight, or nine main notes. Various styles or tats each have different notes in their scales and are played at different seasons and at different times of the day or evening or night. Example scales with seven notes here. These ragas all have paintings that go with them to illustrate the feelings they evoke. But the meaning of each raga revolves around three elements. Color, passion, melody. Color, passion, melody. And in art, that often involves Radha and Krishna. The word raga actually is derived from ranja, meaning color. I'll get to the specific ragas and ragamala paintings pretty soon. Bharata Muni wrote the very ancient Sanskrit Natya Shastra, written between 400 before the Common Era and 200 of our era. It includes a treatise on music and dance as well as his dramatic theory. In that text, Muni first set down the symbolisms of the ragas as emotions in color. Emotions in color. In the 1100s, Sarangadeva wrote the Sangita Ratnakara, the first documented work on South Indian classical music. He posited a presiding deity of each raga, a god or goddess. They are brought to earth by the incantations of musicians. Then Jayadeva is considered one of the greatest of all Sanskrit poets and composers. He was much influenced by the eroticism of the rising Krishna cult. Living in Orissa in the early 1200s, he wrote the Gita Govinda, setting it to music for devotional singing, all glorifying the divine love of Krishna and Radha. It is the song of the cowherd, Gita Govinda. As Jayadeva wrote, emotional qualities are given to each of the ragas by the emphasis placed on certain of its notes. For laughter and love, the fourth and fifth are used. In the heroic mode, and in anger and in wonder, the tonic fifth and sixth. In peace, the fourth. He even indicated the qualities of individual notes of the seven-note scale. The tonic is bright like lotus petals, he wrote. The second is tawny or like a parrot. The minor third is golden, and the fourth like jasmine. The fifth is Krishna, the dark one, who attracts. The sixth is yellow, and the minor seventh is many-hued. Now we notice an attendant here on the left, holding a fly whisk made from the tail of a yak, and one on the right holds a fan. These indicate very proper care of the main person. Then Ramamatya of South India wrote a short work in 1550 entitled Svaramelakalanidhi. In this 25-page treatise, he revolutionized the theory and practice of music in both South and North India. He defined a theoretical 14-tone scale, which he set down as a 12-tone tuning. He specified the implementation of this tuning by describing the location of 6 frets on his veena. All of it is way too complex to get into here, but based on this scale and tuning, Ramamatya defined an abstract raga category called mela raga, or fundamental raga. He used it to accurately classify over 60 janya ragas, or ragas derived from the basic ones, all Carnatic ragas, lots of classifications. Because Indian music is inherently melodic in nature, musicians have created really thousands of different ragas. A bewildering number of them, and very little agreement as to how they should be organized. The point is, painters began to follow, mainly Rajput and Bihari artists. In the medieval era, poets began composing raga garlands to express the feelings that they got from the music. Finally, a grand classification of all ragas and raginis was set down in the late 1500s by the Sikh Guru Arjun in the Guru Granth Sahib, the most sacred texts of the Sikhs. Notice that each of the 6 main or parent ragas, Bhairava, Malkosh, etc., has 5 wives and 8 sons or putras, so a 22-note scale can be used in 84 different ways. 6 parents, 30 raginis, and 48 sons. So there can be 84 different Ragamala paintings as well. It is the Sikh version of things. These Ragamala illustrations were usually created in sets, expressing the meaning of music, the color, through painting. Sometimes daughters-in-law were included too. The
paintings color the heart and mind of the beholder, as these archetypal images are evoked by the music. This is called Bhupali Ragini. But often there is not any similarity between ragas and their raginis and their sons. They color. Now in these kind of paintings, the pictorial frame and text are not a mere background or foreground, but the frame is integrated as if celestial and earthly space is one and the same, thus creating an entirely unique viewpoint.
The flora and fauna, trees, lotuses, animals, and clouds, all have symbolic importance. The poems that relate to the music and paintings were written either on the margins or on the backs of these pictures. According to very religious tantric Hindus, the painted raga should function as a yantra would for realizing yogic spiritual states, a yantra.
Brahma is worshipped here, called Kambavati Ragini. The focus of this raga is devotion to Brahma. The common aim of the poet and the painter was to provide pleasure to the hearer or viewer so that poetry, music, and painting could move hand in hand. The picture, the verse, and the raga all expressing the flavor of the moment chosen. One modern writer has said, "The 9 moods of this dramatic art are love, laughter, compassion, heroism, anger, fear, disgust, wonder, and peace. The nine moods. Now, the very earliest Ragamala art was painting done in Jain manuscripts, like this one on palm leaf. But its real development dates from the 1500s at the court of Baz Bahadur in Mandu, Rajasthan. This is him, supposedly, riding with his favorite Rupmati. And in Bijapur, in the court of Ibrahim Adil Shah. They were both great patrons of the arts and encouraged the fantasies of combining music, poetry, painting together. Folios of paintings were usually sets of 36 or sets of 42. Let's go back to the music again briefly, the ragas. They should reflect the tensions in the singer's spirit and should evoke certain images or rhythms and pictorial associations in the listener. Now, six are male or parent ragas, a standard throughout India, really. But the number of raginis varies in different regions, mainly Punjab, Rajasthan, Kangra. The Sikh tradition has 84 ragas and raginis, as we saw. But another music system has 74, or like here, 72 in all, 6x6 and doubled, red and blue. The Mukund Melakarta Raga chart. And another tradition has this as the complete compendium of ragas, 66 in all in this version, 10x6, painted on cloth actually. Sometimes deities, planets, or animals were connected with ragas. One should hear the raga when looking at the picture. But the great majority of Ragamala painters postulated a scheme of 36 raga raginis, as in this chart. So this is the one I will roughly follow to explain specific paintings. Many names differ from earlier groupings. It's all very complex, actually. The six primary ragas are on the left: Bhairava, Malkosh, Hindola, Dipak, Megh and Shri. I'll follow that order with one or more examples of many of them. Other names toward the right are wives, that is, raginis, and sons, ragaputras, and sometimes their wives. It's kind of crazy. These schemes were no longer used by the 19th century. They were often seen as corresponding to the seasons: summer, monsoons, autumn, early winter, winter, and spring, but not always in the same order. Generally, male ragas typify courage, valor, anger, and wonder, and other such so-called masculine emotions, with many variations, of course. These are four raginis, all painted together, signifying love, sorrow, laughter, and compassion, said to be feminine emotions. There are lots of variations and inconsistencies, and modern musicians see no relevant connection between the music, poetry, and art. Modern musicians do not see the connection between all of this. We go first to Bhairava Raga, the first of the six major systems here. This is said to be awe-inspiring and expresses the fulfillment of the desire of worship, worshiping Shiva. Performed before sunrise between 3 and 6 a.m. and in the autumn. Very solemn. This raga is one of awesome grandeur of Shiva Bhairava, not of Krishna. Imagine a feeling of approaching dawn, the caroling of birds, the sweetness of the perfume in the air, the sparkling freshness of a dewdrop morning. In praise of him, this verse is sung. O Shiva, beauteous in every limb, your face luminous with a spiritual glow, your body smeared with ashes, the forefinger and thumb of your hand meeting to show the antelope's head. The antelope's head is a mudra. O keeper of cosmic order, in whom all life begins and ends, this raga spells out your rhythmic image, O Bhairava. Bhairavi Ragini here. Bhairavis on the left, praying to Shiva Bhairava at the Shivalingam, his phallic form. She uses symbols for chanting hymns, The strong use of colors symbolizes her ardent aspiration and passion. This raga should be played any time in the morning after sunrise. Often, traditionally, Bhairavi worships bare-breasted. Or Bhairavi can focus on her worship on Shiva's bull, called Nandi. For many of these ragamalas, detailed information is missing, or lost, or maybe never even written. Nataraga, a son of Bhairava, is visualized in the form of acrobats performing physical feats, pole climbing, exercising with weights. Afternoon raga, this is. Nat actually means both to weigh and to acrobat, as in to gain weight by exercising like an acrobat, or by riding horseback, or by practicing combat, actually fighting in a way. The raga should be played in the afternoon. Sometimes this son's name is Disak Raga, in one of the larger classifications, but looking just like Nat Raga anyway. Looks like Nat Raga again, but Disak Raga. Well, doesn't really matter. The use of perspective is rather interesting here. They're working out area from above, but they and the scenery in the background from the side, rather typical of a lot of Indian art. Malashri Ragini is another wife of Bhairava. She's a beautiful woman, but nervously preparing a bed in a garden. She has gathered red lotus petals in round leaf baskets and is scattering them around on the bed. There's lots of lilies and poppies and carnations growing too. Even the bedspread echoes the rather vivid flowers. In other versions, Malashri plucks the lotus petals in that anxious game of does he love me, does he not? She has to be cooled by her maidservant. The empty bed plus peacocks and deer emphasize her ardent longing. She pretends the lotus petals are her lover's skin. The mood is of beauty created in anticipation of a perfect lover's tryst, but uneasy feeling in her stomach nonetheless. Tension, even nausea. Malasri means relieving the nausea. Punyaki Ragini, another wife, gives alms to the wandering mendicants, or begging holy men. Patamanjari Ragini. Here, this fifth wife and her comrade discuss problems of love, and her friend gives her plenty of advice. And always she gives more advice. The dear confidant is always an important person in relationships, as well as in art. Lalita Ragini, a raga to be played before sunrise as her lover departs from their bedchamber. Lalita means a charming, beautiful woman, even rather loose in her ways, perhaps, a wife of Bhairava. Lalita, the happy mistress, resplendently beautiful, lies exhausted with love on her bed at dawn, as it is written. We come to the second major system here, Malkosh. Malkosh Raga, another parent raga, dramatic late-night raga. Any season will do, actually, as long as it's played very late. Malkosh is usually portrayed as a heroic lord eating pan, and certainly well looked after by his wife. The effect of this raga is said to produce a feeling of gentle stimulation. Maybe the effect of eating pan helps. The inscription here reads, "A scarf around his neck and fanned by the fair-hipped one. A golden seat has been made for the king of the Gandharvas, handsome and wealthy."
Gauri Ragini, as Malkosh's first wife, is a late afternoon or evening raga and is assigned especially to autumn. Its mood is very contemplative.
Sometimes the dark evening sky is shown, but not always. Gauri actually means style, style. In this case, it's the style and mode to remember God and to sing His glories. Peaceful and tranquil is the evening. Gauri also refers to Parvati, shining, brilliant goddess, formidable woman, as the consort of another Raga, Raga Shri. Very devotional in feeling, Gauri Ragini. Malava Ragini. Here two lovers approach their bedchamber. The attendant stays behind, of course. This raga is to be played in the afternoon. The name Malava comes from the state of Malwa in Rajasthan. It's said that she urges him to delay no longer, but allows him to lead her within and to the bed. The raga's melody is one of emotional anticipation. Ramakali Ragini is a morning raga performed before daybreak, between 3 and 6 a.m., and usually during the hot season. Here she spurns her lover, her husband Malkosh. "But I am entirely devoted to you," he says. The mood of the music should inspire lofty thoughts to rise above the differences in their relationships. Ramakali firmly rebuffs her repentant lover, kneeling before her. Gunkari Ragini. Another wife sits outside of a palace on a terrace at night, close to daybreak, waiting for her husband to return. The bed is ready, and she cleans the flowering bush and picks a few petals. The couch is prepared with cushions, ready for the lover. Gunkari Ragini is always played at daybreak. Pots of flowers are always shown, and all activity indicates anticipation of his arrival. The third main parent raga is Hindola, Hindola raga. It means a swing that's specially used during the rainy season. The raga should be played in the early morning, and we should imagine the rhythm of the swing and the girl singing matching that of the instrument. And imagine the sweetness and freshness of spring, sweet as the honey of the bee and fragrant as the perfume of a thousand blossoms. One inspired poet composed the following verse. Enjoying frolicsome delight on a swing, gently pushed by fair-hipped maidens, he is called by the great sages Hindola Raga, with complexion bright as that of a pigeon. This raga has a very gentle mood, represents loneliness and quiet joy, and is performed in a dignified, slow tempo. Another poet has written of Hindola as a woman, a ragini. My heart dreams of the firm-breasted Hindola with broad hips, who wears bright-colored clothes. With a flower of the lotus, she worships Lord Krishna. She hears the notes of his flute. Her heart full of love, her beautiful limbs adorned with jewels. And Vallaval Ragini. The anxious wife of Hindola ties her hair and adorns herself using a mirror held by her attendant. This is an early morning raga, meant to be peaceful and refreshing. In this case, her blue skin indicates that she's smeared herself with ashes, as an ascetic would do, to give her supernatural powers. That helps to ensure her lover's safe return to her. The red skirt and bodice match the red in the alcoves, symbolizing her passionate longing. This is more simple without much symbolism. Vallaval Ragini signifies strong, amorous expectation in preparing for her lover to come. Todi Ragini, a wife who tames wild animals that are attracted to her. Here she will play music for them by the lotus pond. She awaits her husband lover in the forest. Todi is a raga for the late morning hours, 9 to 12 noon, and the mood is very gentle and blissful, with an aura of adoration. Usually gazelles or deer are shown, but sometimes other animals too. Words composed for this raga emphasize that no matter what problems one meets or what worldly affairs distract the mind, devotion to the Lord brings one back to the path of release from worldliness. Madhu Madhavi Ragini, a wife raga for the late evening that specifically plays with colors. She plays with colors. She rushes in from the upcoming storm to be with her husband, who waits inside for her on a night like this. Since Madhu means honey or ghee, and Madhavi means woman, Madhu Madhavi Ragini is the wife of Hindola, who is as sweet as honey and butter, and retreats from the nasty weather to be with her lover. So it's called candle music. Candle music, always outside. Dipak means lamp, luminous, bright. Music of the burning flame. Flowers, music, lamps glowing. If this Dipak raga is played correctly, all lamps will be amazingly lit spontaneously. And it will burn the musician, as they say. Supposedly, it caused the body of a singer to produce flames by which he died. So this raga is extinct. No one could sing it and live. Dipak raga is played in the morning or evening by instrumentalists, but only in the hot season. So all the scenes are outside, with Dipak and his wife being well entertained. Gyan Shri Ragini is a wife who's left alone, pining away, and tries to paint a portrait of her missing husband. Here with an attendant holding the color palette. Sometimes it is said she cries as she paints the image of her absent lover. It is an early afternoon raga, played between 12 and 3. Kannada raga is played at midnight as a son of Dipak. In one version of this raga, it is said, all the women have come into the forest. The name implies that this raga came from the south, Karnataka. And here is a very different version of the raga. Kannada raga was once an elephant hunter's song to honor the slayer of the elephant. The picture equates the courage to slay an elephant with Lord Krishna, as well as with a victorious king. Bhairava Ragini is the fourth wife of Dipak, here waiting for him to arrive and looking quite distraught. Although this picture doesn't seem to relate to the next one, they both are supposedly illustrating the same Ragini. Here she adores her lover, the musical prince, letting him adore her, but she still keeps a yak-tail flywhisk ready to use, if need be, for his comfort. As a musical princess, she will fan the flames of love. Desavarati Ragini is Dipak's fifth wife. It's played in the late morning. It's perhaps a farewell scene as a servant offers betel to the couple, and the horse seems ready to ride. Megh Raga is the fifth parent raga. This is of the rains, the monsoons, overhanging dark storm clouds. And life is indoors, mostly, except between showers. Mega wears yellow for his dance. This means a rain cloud raga, which can extinguish the bright lights that the Dipak raga had caused suddenly to ignite, so it is said. Imagine the effects of an approaching thunderstorm, relieving the drought. The ancients tell of Megha Raga, lustrous like a blue lotus, the divine smile of his moon-like face is sweeter than ambrosia. Clothed in yellow in the midst of heavy clouds, he shines among the heroes, as it is said. Gujari Ragini, a wife of Megha, is a melody of the dawn and the monsoon season. As it is said, she rests on a couch of soft sandal tree leaves outdoors. Lovely, graceful, and with fine hair, her fingers are positioned on the veena, distinguishing between the seven notes. Or on a porch, in this case with peacocks nearby. It is a solemn and very devotional raga played between 9 and noon in the morning. As a ragini, Gujari is often followed by a pair of gazelles, which are taken by her beauty. She plays for them, and they represent her lovers. In Rajasthani summers, the deserts often shimmer with mirages, so that thirsty people and animals believe a shimmering lake is not far off. Herds of deer travel for miles until they lay down their lives. Deer thirst, as it's called, rather symbolic of love. Kakuba Ragini is the third wife of Megha Raga, Kakuba. She is out in the forests and fields, communing with various animals, especially peacocks and other birds. We have a strong connection with nature, a sweet little temple here. Lotus pond below, monkeys in the trees. This looks much like Kakuba Ragini, but she is called Sarati Ragini, according to some Ragamala system. She's always with peacocks and pining for her absent lover, who is Raga Megha. And she has a white rabbit and veena, along with peacocks, alone and yearning. Vibhasa Ragini is a Ragini of the dawn, as the wife of Megha. While she sleeps in her palace bedchamber, her lover prepares to depart at daybreak. Holding a floral bow, he prepares to shoot a lotus-tipped arrow to his love as goodbye, like that of the love god Kama. The symbolism is here enhanced by different segments of the painting of the divided lovers on a veranda with their early morning memories and fantasies. The central one with a doorway is the focus, with both of their hands communicating there. And the go-between friend and the bush flowering is there too. A space and rite of passage. Vipassa Ragini. Bengal Raga is a son who becomes an ascetic. He has a small hut out in nature, prayer beads in his hand. A tiger or other wildcat always accompanies him. Bongo. Living life alone in prayer, meditating, making offerings to his God. Bangal Ragini is the fifth wife of Megha Raga, also an ascetic, taking yogic postures, reading sacred scriptures. Her hut looks like a shrine or a temple. She fills her jar with Ganges water or wears clothes of birch bark, according to one text. Ragini Bangala became an ascetic because she felt tortured by separation from her husband. But here she has plenty of support and not very ascetic surroundings. Shankara Bharana Ragaputra is another son of Megha in the 84 Raga system. With the name Shankara, Ganesh and his brother are worshipping him as their father Shiva. The Ganges River flows out from below his shrine. A more simple version here of worshipping Shiva Shankar in the Himalayas, where the Ganges begins. And finally, Sri Raga, the last parent Raga. Sri means respected. Its mood is one of majesty combined with prayerful meditation. Sri also means supreme, exalted, the first place of Ragas. The Raga is performed during the rainy season as well as in the winter. This is sung in the evening for Sri, a nobleman here at sunset, solemn and grave. As it is said, man's mind and his inner state is immortal as one of darkness, caused by Maya and ignorance of his spiritual potentialities. We must imagine calmness and silence of the declining day, tinging the thoughts with a roseate hue as clouds are gilded by the setting sun before the approach of darkness and night. As one poet put it, the lordly Sri Raga sits in a beautiful mansion while someone waves a fly whisk over him. Contemplating the Raga's splendor, the bridegroom gains perfect concentration of mind. One series of Sri Ragamala paintings includes a special singer, the ancient rishi Narada, who wanders about earth and heaven singing and playing his veena. Narada taught music to humankind. He is accompanied by a horse-headed musician known as the celestial Kinnara. Literally, it means what kind of man. In another translation, it is written, splendidly enthroned, of peerless beauty and lovely as the autumn moon, he sits hearing stories from Narada and Tumvara. By the great sages, he is called Sri Raga King. He sits in a beautiful mansion as a lady waves a fly whisk over him, contemplating the splendor of the Sri Raga. The groom is perfectly concentrated in mind. The Kinnara appears only in the imagery of these Sri Raga Ragamalas. Here the musician is a woman. Kamodi Ragini. She is a wife of Sri. This is played in the early night when the bed is ready. He is ready, but she apparently is not. As a young lady in love, her curved eyebrows show some anger. The inscription reads, as if Ragini Kamodi were angry, she turns away. Malhar Raga, a son of Sri, involved in religious ritual here. Malhar represents a group of ragas to be played during the rainy season or at midnight anytime. Lotuses and birds. Playing a Malhar Raga is supposed to produce rain, so this is a soothing and refreshing raga. A prayer goes with this one, as if she is actually an ascetic lady. I meditate upon Malhar, who constantly worships Shiva, the Lord of Sleep. Pure, she rests surrounded with the lotuses of the cool season below the divine tree of ages. Her pure, pale body has the glow of the winter clouds. Kadara Ragini, that's another wife. Now she's actually the focus here, but not seen in the painting. This raga is supposed to possess magical qualities, if it's performed correctly, which can actually heal the sick. Always it's a night scene with moon and stars seen. Here, a monk holds a musical instrument but on the left, a seeker who wants to forget his lover, Kadara, holds a rosary and is learning the correct yoga positions. A band or banda is used around him to support his left knee, and a particular stick under his right shoulder to keep him in the correct spiritual position. The always-present peacock on the roof symbolizes divine love. The mood of this raga is contemplation associated with ascetic idealism. This raga is played in the summer, in the fourth part of the day, and in the first quarter of the night, and is particularly auspicious when the moon is visible. But it is said that he yearns so much for his love that he leaves the monk and returns the next day to his lover, Kadara. So much for spirituality in this case. The last couple, wife Raginis of Shri, seem to be the weirdest of all, with snakes. Ramakala Ragini offers milk to a snake in the forest. And Asavari Ragini is a wife raga to be played in the late morning. A woman fluting to bring down snakes from sandalwood trees to console her. She is very unhappy, looking for her absent lover. This is an early dawn raga. As it is written, Asavari, with shining dark skin, is adorned with peacock feathers and a necklace of rare splendid pearls. She, on the mountaintop, drags forth the snakes from the sandal trees and wears one as a girdle. We'll finish up now with one last raga, Vasant or Vasant Raga, a son of Dipak, actually, in the 36 raga system, and a son of Hindol in another system, doesn't matter, and his wife, Vasant Ragini. It is a celebration of spring with musicians in concert. Vasant comes from the Sanskrit Vasant, meaning spring, and during that season, the raga may be performed at any time of the day or night. Otherwise, it's reserved for the evening. Pairs of lovers, of course, the flowering trees. Vasant Raga goes with Vasant Ragini, as Lord Krishna goes with his lady Radha. These images could go with either Raga or Raginis, as the imagery is very much the same. Often pots or vases of plants or flowers are used as symbolic of spring. Here, Radha presents one to Krishna. Krishna usually wears yellow at this time of year and has a crown of peacock feathers and dances. Trees and lotuses in bloom, all symbolic of spring. The musicians represent individual human souls wishing a union with him, the Supreme. They are in the garden made to play, one text says, in swarms of bees so keen on the scent of flowers with fresh leaves. The spring putting on the shape of Krishna is the song they sing. There is a kind of frivolous and zealous character of the music and paintings both. Even the cock, the rooster, sings the musical mode, the sound of the spring, as it was written. This raga is meant to emphasize the role of Krishna as hero, a Nayik, enjoying spring at the important holy festival, especially popular in North India. The Sant Raga is designated as a secondary mode or ragini in some traditional and musical texts. However, in the paintings, it's always projected as a masculine character, often but not always Lord Krishna. The poetry also treats the melody as a male form. Finally now, Jayadeva, in the early 1200s, wrote about Vasant and springtime with a very symbolic Krishna and his musician girlfriends, symbols of human longing for the divine. Krishna made for heavenly things, mid those woodland singers sings. With those dancers, dances featly, gives back soft embraces sweetly. Smiles on that one, toys with this, glance for glance and kiss for kiss. Meets the merry damsels fairly, plays the round of folly rarely. Lapped in milk-warm springtime weather. He and those brown girls together, and this shadowed earthly love, in the twilight of the grove, dance and song and soft caressed, meeting looks and tangled tresses. Jayadev, the same hath writ, that ye might have the gain of it. Sagely its deep sense conceiving, and its inner light believing, how that love the mighty master, lord of all the stars that cluster in the sky, lord of swiftest and of slowest, lord of highest, lord of lowest, manifests himself to mortals, winning them toward the portals of his secret house, the gates of that bright paradise which waits the wise in love.